Konnichiwa.
All right, guys. Welcome to the Hot Johnson. This week, we're going to be talking about anxiety. We thought it would be very beneficial to really dive into this topic because so many of us feel it, yet we don't understand, like, why are we feeling anxiety? Mm-hmm. Because it is trying to communicate something to us. And how can we address it and heal it if we don't understand it?
That's right.
We also have a giveaway. Our first giveaway. I feel like we need a little... So we've got a giveaway that we're going to be doing at the end of the episode. So stay tuned for that.
Yes.
Okay, let's dive right in. So we're going to break this kind of into three different categories as to why you might be experiencing anxiety. So Bron, the first one being kind of mental, emotional, things that are going on in our heads. I'm really curious for you and your practice with your clients. What are you really seeing with people, or why is that coming up for people?
Whenever I think of someone having anxiety, or whenever one of my clients has anxiety, the first thing that I get them to do is to check in with their body. Our anxiety is always trying to tell us something. It always has a story connected to it. And that can always be acknowledged when we stop and we take a deep breath and we connect with the feeling inside of our bodies.
Mm.
And when we talk about what does it look like to process it, what does it look like to heal it? Self-awareness is key. One of my favorite questions to ask people when they're feeling anxiety is, if your anxiety could talk, what would it say? And I challenge people to don't ask the anxiety from their head, ask it from their body, ask it from your heart, go right into the feeling. Because sometimes when we filter the anxiety through our head, it's not always accurate.
Totally.
But it really is a practice to drop down, take a deep breath, and ask yourself, ask your heart, ask where it's showing up in your body. If my anxiety could talk right now, what would it say? And just the practice, just the process of bringing awareness to it and allowing your anxiety to speak is so therapeutic, because now it's not just living inside your body. Totally. You're actually giving it a voice outside of yourself, whether that means journaling it, or communicating it to someone, a good friend, someone that you trust,
a counselor, a coach, therapist.
Yeah. Your anxiety needs a place to move out of. And we're going to get into that as well.
Yeah.
But right now, the first step to addressing anxiety that's manifesting in a psychological or emotional form is bringing awareness to it. Feel it. I always tell people, what we resist will always
persist.
That's right.
Yeah.
The hair trigger response for so many of us is to push it away. It's like, I don't want to feel this anxiety. And that's why so many of us use vices, addictive behaviors, gambling, sex, drugs, shopping, porn, whatever, to push away from the feelings inside our body. And that resistance, it's just prolonging it.
Totally.
And so what I say to people, what you resist persists. If you want to heal, you have to
feel. Yeah. No, it's so cool. I mean, you pretty much just spoke to everything that I was going to say that we're talking about in school right now. When someone is experiencing anxiety, is someone who's essentially avoiding themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And it's why a lot of us keep ourselves so busy. You know, if you are that person who just, you can't be still, you can't be and sit with yourself, because when we do get quiet, when the busy go, go, go stops, then you are left with your emotions, you are left with your thoughts. And I mean, that's shit that you've got to deal with. So anxiety is really an avoidance of self. And it's exactly what Bron was talking about. To help heal that, evolve that, is to just acknowledge it, to be with it, to stop avoiding it. And it's really amazing once you actually do just name it, see it, make space for it, how it kind of just processes.
That's
you
right.
know, the emotion comes up, you deal with it, and it does dissolve.
We can't underestimate the power of seeing something for what it really is, shining the light of your own awareness, if you will, onto it. Mm-hmm. There's something about being a witness to the emotions inside your body that brings your nervous system from a dysregulated state to a regulated state.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, by noticing it. I also do want to speak to those who have experienced things that are super traumatic and maybe have some PTSD. And there is such overwhelm in facing those things. I want to speak to that a little bit, because that is a real thing for a lot of people. And I think therapy in the past was all about dig in, just, you know, face it, confront it. And a lot of these, I don't know about you, but workshops and things that I've done in the past were just full blown, all in, feel it deeply. And that is not the best for everyone, especially for somebody who does have extensive trauma and PTSD. That in itself, revisiting the topic that way for some people can be re-traumatizing in itself. Absolutely. So this is where working, you know, with a trusted and educated coach or a counselor to be able to address those things, revisit them and deal with them, still feel them. But we refer to it as in your window of tolerance. So when you're like talking about it and revisiting it, it's done in a way where you still feel safe. You still feel okay. And you're not getting so activated by talking about it and revisiting it that then for the next week, you're just like an anxious wreck and you can't deal with life anymore.
I love what you just said. It's so important.
It really, really is.
It's so important when processing, addressing any kind of emotion is to be so gentle with ourselves. That's so key.
And to just meet yourself where you're at.
Yes.
Like knowing what feels okay for you, and healing doesn't happen overnight, right? It's a journey. So if you can only talk about, you know, the top layer right now and that feels safe and okay to do, then that meet yourself there. And as time goes on, you're probably going to be able to go deeper and deeper into it. I think the other thing that Bron and I were talking a little bit about is when it comes to anxiety, you know, these thoughts and emotions that we are avoiding, they can be things from the past. They also can be things presently in your life. So maybe your anxiety is because of something that happened a long time ago that you are avoiding, that you've tried to put away because you don't want to feel it. You don't want to think about it. That could be causing anxiety. There's also a legitimacy to it could be something in your present day life right now at work, a really stressful event. Your boss is a total ass. And like, you know, maybe you need to have a hard conversation. You need to deal with it. You need to make some changes, change your job. If you're also avoiding that, that can cause anxiety. So I think in a nutshell, I really see anxiety as being avoidance of self.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So what are you avoiding in yourself right now? Mm-hmm. What needs to be felt, thought about, and addressed? Because mm-hmm. it's the weight of having that on you. It's funny because I think a lot of us, when it comes to anxiety and these thoughts and emotions, we're trying to like escape them. And I think of this analogy of like being in the rain. Like I think of these thoughts and these anxious emotions as like being in the rain where you're like, I don't want to get wet. So you're trying to avoid it. But if you just go out in the rain and let yourself just get freaking drenched, like just... it feels good, right? Like you ever go like, just like dance or run in the rain?
Yeah.
So it's the same thing with our anxiety and our thoughts and our emotions. It's like we try to avoid, but if you confront it and you deal with it, it's going to feel so much better. And then it's not always hanging on your back and your shoulders trying to gnaw its way in. Like it's trying to communicate to you because it wants to be addressed.
Well, and the nervous system is trying to communicate to you that if you do this thing, whatever you're anxious about, you're going to die or there's a potential of death. Your body's just trying to protect you from perceived mortal threat.
Yeah.
And when we can get in the gap between external stimulus and our response to it and remind ourselves, our bodies, we hold ourselves again gently and say, I'm okay. I'm not going to die. I'm okay. I'm not going to die, mm-hmm. or I am safe. I think another really important reminder too is that this whole practice is really taking us to a level of creating and cultivating courage within ourselves.
Oh yeah, totally.
It takes a profound amount of vulnerability to start to feel these emotions. And with the vulnerability is a call to cultivate courage.
Totally. 1,000%. It's freaking scary to confront a lot of these things. Mm-hmm. It really, really is. Mm-hmm. And once again, I think it's just important to meet yourself where you're at, be with someone that you trust, a trusted counselor, coach, whatever, to help you navigate through that if you don't feel equipped to be able to do that on your own.
Absolutely.
Like support and help is there for a reason. You know, even I've been in counseling, coaching my entire life. Like I see the value in having that support and somebody helping you see your blind spots. Cause so often we have these thoughts that maybe you don't even see what your thoughts are. So having someone outside of you to kind of call you out on that stuff is so helpful.
Absolutely.
Number two. So the second thing that we talk a little bit about when it comes to why you might be feeling anxiety is more physical, things that are going on in your physical body. And the first thing that I think about is Peter Levine. If you've checked out his stuff and his books, he talks about, for example, when an animal is out in the wild and is like being chased and is going through a traumatic experience, after you will actually see, and they filmed footage of this, of animals in the wild who will be like, they'll be shaking, shake, they shake. Yeah. And that helps to dispense that nervous system energy, because when something traumatic or distressing happens to us and our nervous system goes into fight or flight, that energy is in, it's activated in your body. And if you're not physically moving it out, or you are in a situation where you weren't able to move at all, like for example, like a car accident.
Yeah, or a natural disaster.
A natural disaster, childbirth for a lot of people. Any things where you were like potentially in a trapped situation where you couldn't move and do what your body wanted to do, which is to run away.
Yes.
So that energy can get stuck in your nervous system and in your body.
That's right.
And this is where doing somatic work, like breath work, for example, in my experience has been very helpful and beneficial of like, that's, I mean, the breath work that I am trained in, that is literally what it does, is it activates that part of your nervous system to like bring that energy that is in your body up.
It sounds uncomfortable.
It's honestly super fucking uncomfortable,
yeah.
But it's potent and it's powerful and it's helpful.
So healing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You're moving things out of your body that you probably didn't even know that you had.
And those things are making you sick, like literally, mentally and physically and emotionally.
Absolutely.
Because when your body is stuck, then that's another component here. When you've had a traumatic experience or something really distressing and your body and your brain literally get stuck in that fight or flight state, mm-hmm. not only are you going to be hyper alert and anxious all the time, like your brain is literally always scanning for danger when your brain is stuck in that state, but it is also really hard for your body on a physical level to heal from any kind of physical illness when you're in a stress response, because all of your body's energy and resources are going to like, well, they're going
protecting
to
yourself.
Yeah. Protecting yourself. Yeah, exactly. So you can't heal when your body is just trying to protect itself.
Yeah.
So that's a really big thing. A lot of us might not even be aware that we have that energy in our body. Like I was saying to Bron earlier this morning, you know, my life, I've done a lot of mental and emotional stuff, which is what we covered in the first point. Mm-hmm. And yet I still felt this anxious energy in my body, this like pulling my hair. And it was like, I had a very traumatic birth. I mean, there's been a number of different things that I've been through in my life where there is just that nervous system energy still in my body. And so doing the breath work, the somatic work, stuff with your body to help move it out, the mind and the body are connected, right? So sometimes just doing cognitive talk work isn't always enough to help with your anxiety. Sometimes it is living inside of your body.
Literally, physically inside your body.
Totally.
Yes.
Yeah. The other thing, which we talked a lot about when I was in nutrition school, which is super interesting, is just anytime there is an imbalance in your body, whether that is a hormonal imbalance, maybe it's something going on with your gut health, you know, the good and the bad bacteria in your gut, your microbiome.
Yeah. Didn't you say that 90% of...
90% of your serotonin, which is your happy hormone, is made in your gut. So the hormone that makes you happy is made in your gut, majority of it. So if you've got any kind of gut infection, a lot of us nowadays have leaky gut. It makes sense, right? It's going to impact that serotonin and it's going to impact your mood a lot.
Absolutely. 90% is pretty profound when you really think of it.
Yeah, it's huge.
So how does one address that? How does one acknowledge where their anxiety is coming from?
Yeah.
Whether it's from the psychological, emotional, or the
physical.
Yeah, or physical. Yes.
Well, I think this is why, for me anyways, I have been passionate about educating and training myself in a number of different modalities, because every person is different. So I can't just like say, for you, it's for sure going to be this. For me, it's for sure going to be that. We're all different. Right. And our imbalances are potentially coming from different places, whether it be mind, body, or soul.
Right.
So it's looking at each one of those for you personally to address where the imbalance may be.
Right.
Number one that we talked about, going and talking with a coach or a counselor to address the mental, emotional side of things. And then if we're talking about the physical, there is, like I said, somatic breath work that you can do if it's trapped energy that's in your body. If it's more so an imbalance with your gut or your hormones, this is where, you know, seeing a naturopath and doing some testing, the Dutch hormone test, I'm a big fan of, gives you a really in-depth look into what is going on specifically with your hormones. So you can see like if your cortisol is all up, your stress hormones. You can also do some gut testing as well. But I mean, if you want to save yourself a couple $100, start eating fermented foods. Sauerkraut, that in itself, if you just have like a big tablespoon of that every day, that's going to boost your good gut bacteria. Eating more fruits and vegetables, which is high in fiber, that feeds your good gut bacteria. And then of course, just like cutting down on junk, sugar, processed foods, alcohol, all those things kill our good gut bacteria. And antibiotics also wipe out all your good gut bacteria as well.
So helpful.
Yeah, such, just a little snapshot for you.
Such valuable information.
Dude, that's, we could do a whole episode just on your microbiome and the impacts that that can have on so many different things. Yeah. In your life.
I just don't think that a lot of people are aware that unhealthy microbiome, unhealthy gut can have such a drastic effect on one's emotions, causing them anxiety.
Okay.
I think we're ready to go into the third reason why people feel anxiety.
So the third thing is just a really quick one, but I think it's really worth mentioning, is just the overwhelm that a lot of us are experiencing these days from the environment that we live in, the world that we live in.
Data overload.
There's so much freaking information coming at us, especially with our cell phones, you know, TV, radio, just like you think of how our grandparents grew up in comparison to now, how peaceful and quiet and slow paced their lives were. Nowadays, the majority of us, you know, we're go, go, go. We're working multiple jobs. We're on our phones right before bed. Like being in that state, even as you're doing it, it's like in that fight or flight mode all the time.
Totally.
And just the excess of information, stimulation, noise coming at you all the time. I think I've heard it somewhere, and I totally agree and believe this to be true, that our bodies have not adapted, you know, going back to where our grandparents were at and how much our society has changed in that regard over the years.
Right.
Our bodies have not caught up to all of this noise, all of this stimulation that is coming at us. And that's like really overwhelming to the system. And so it makes sense that that would cause some anxiety.
Totally. I mean, our grandparents and our ancestors experienced a way different level of life-threatening experiences.
Yeah, they had like legit war and stuff like that.
Yeah. But what you're saying is today, the level in which we're exposed to information and data through our phones, TV, it's on a level that has never been experienced to our species before.
And just the pressures, you know, you talk to most people nowadays and it's like, you know, back in the day, you could probably just live off of one income. You could have a family where the dad went to work and the mom was a stay-at-home mom. Most families nowadays, that is not a reality.
Definitely.
We're all having to work to be able to afford the cost of living. People are getting burnt out and it just, yeah, it's just, it's a lot. I've had clients in the past where they experienced a lot of anxiety, and a lot of the times it was because of the scrolling, being on the phone all the time, and specifically at night,
right?
You know? So if we want to try to offer up a solution for that, I mean, it would just be to be mindful of the amount of information that you're taking in and to consciously try to create some space for some peace and quiet for yourself. I remember when I was in nutrition school, we talked about, you know, every night your brain needs a certain period of time to like download and process all of the information that your eyes have taken in throughout the day. And if you're on your phone all the way until you close your eyes at night, your brain doesn't get any quiet time throughout the day to download and to do that. Your brain needs a period of absolute quiet, no stimulation, to download and process everything that you've taken in throughout the day. So if you're not creating a space for that in at some point throughout your waking hours before you go to bed, then it's doing that while you're trying to sleep. Mm-hmm. And that is really going to impact your sleep. And if you're having shitty sleeps, that could be a potential part of it.
That's right. In fact, some people come to me for hypnotherapy and they don't realize it, but that's actually the biggest value that they're getting is because when you're in that state of hypnosis, your body, your subconscious mind is in that state where it can process all of the data in which you are supposed to be processing when you're sleeping.
Yeah.
But in that hypnotic state, it's beautiful. They say that 1 hour of hypnosis is equivalent to about 8 hours of sleep. And that's why.
Shit. Why are we all not getting hypnosis from Braun every day?
Let's go.
That would be so, it could save on so much time sleeping. Why are you not hypnotizing me every day?
I don't know.
You haven't asked.
Well, I am now.
Maybe I should book in.
I don't want to sleep so much. It's taking up so much of my time. We're doing a podcast. We're going to school. We got shit to do.
We got a lot to do. So what is the hot offer?
Yeah. Would you like to communicate it, or do you want me to?
It would be my pleasure. Why don't we both do it?
Okay.
The hot offer for this week for all of you when we talk about anxiety, because really the reason why you're here is to get answers of not only why am I experiencing anxiety? Obviously, we just addressed that. But how do we really process that? And we touched a little bit on that, but I'd like you to follow along and really take this process into your life and to remember that this isn't something that you just do once. We do it over and over and over again every time our anxiety comes up. So the next time you feel anxiety in your life, I want you to stop and I want you to take a nice long deep breath in. Your natural response up until now is to resist it, is to run away from it, is to indulge in any kind of behavior that would distract you from your anxiety. I invite you to do the opposite and to practice cultivating the courage to address it head on. Be gentle with yourself. See if you can tune into where the anxiety is showing up, manifesting in your body, whether it's your heart, your gut, your neck, your hands, your back, your lower body. Just be present with it. Don't try to change it. Don't try to move it. Don't try to run away from it. Just be present with it. Feel it. If you want to heal, you have to feel. And now that you're present with it, ask that anxiety in your body, what does it need? If it could talk, what would it say? Practice cultivating compassion for yourself as your body is experiencing this anxiety moving through. And see if you can meet that anxiety with the compassion in which you would meet a child that has hurt themselves, that is crying. See if you can meet that anxiety in your body with that level of love and compassion. And to just ask, what do you need right now? And let it respond and just listen. And sometimes all the anxiety needs is to be heard. Mm-hmm. So much of the time, what it takes to heal our unprocessed negative emotions is to just be heard and listened to so that it has a chance to move out from that stuck place out into the open. Mm-hmm. And when we can practice being present and bringing our nervous system from that dysregulated state back into a regulated state by giving it new messaging, which is, I am safe. Connect with yourself. I am loved. I'm okay. When you can make that a practice throughout your life, little by little, day by day, you're going to notice that the frequency in which you experience the anxiety is going to go down. And the intensity in which you experience the anxiety is also going to go down. Practice, practice, practice. Anything else to add on that?
Ultimately, where are you avoiding yourself? What are you avoiding? Can you confront it? And just knowing that the reward in doing that is worth it. It is so worth it. We go through our lives with this weight that we are carrying in trying to avoid ourselves. Wouldn't it feel nice to get that shit off your shoulders? Mm-hmm. Fuck. Mm-hmm. It feels good. Mm-hmm. It's like you said, it's hard. It's not the most fun of work, but it's the rewards are so worth it.
Yeah. More joy.
Speaking of joy, should we do our giveaway?
Yeah. What's the giveaway, Janae Johnson?
Yeah. Okay. So we have a $100 gift card to Nature's Fair. which is here in the Okanagan, the grocery store in the Okanagan, also in the Lower Mainland. They got the best of the best groceries. That's exclusively where I shop. Everything is organic, grass-fed meats, organic meats. And actually every week on social media, I also put up recipes with ingredients that have been purchased from Nature's Fair. So if you're wanting some tips on recipes and meal prepping and stuff like that, feel free to check that out. But we do have a $100 gift card to give away from Nature's Fair.
$100.
$100!
What do they need to do to enter tonight?
Yeah, so if you want to enter to win, you can just like, comment, and subscribe to our channel, this video, and we're going to give the $100 gift card away on the 25th.
Of August, next week.
Yeah. So, yeah, if you want some free groceries, groceries ain't cheap these days.
It's going to be great.
Hit it up. Hit it up. Okay, let's play your shitty music to get out of here. Where is it? Here we go.
Oh, what? What's this?
Bronze dance break.
I don't know if you've ever seen this before.
Yeah, I think we saw it in the first, the second video.
Oh, damn. What's this? Hey, what's this? Uh-oh.
I actually never want to see that again. Have a great week, you guys.
Bye.
See you next week.